Alright, let's see how my plans are going. The plane sequel is already getting complacent by the diehard animation geeks, and that job is getting just as much negativity as Freebirds, and a lot of praise for the Lego Movie, Peabody and Sherman, and Rio 2. Look at that, Rio. Can be a video begin to already.
Hello, CGI.
Toonmore. Wait, how were you able to get my Skype? Have it on private.
Diamanda Hagen gave it to me, on the condition that I have to do a co-review with her someday.
Normally, I'd laugh at the idea, but considering the film she suggested to Hardcore Kid, ugh. Even I have my own standards. Regardless, what do you want?
I've come to ask you to please remove the curse from my keyboard just this one time.
You think it's going to be that easy?
Come on, Count. My fans are begging me to review Disney's Frozen. Please, just remove the curse this one time. This one time. I'll do anything.
You're that desperate to see one new movie out in theaters.
I can't let my fans down. They've been wanting me to review the movie for over a year now. Besides, I've already reviewed 2 bad movies in a row, one Christmas-related. I think I deserve to watch something good this holiday season.
You know what, Toonmore? Go right ahead.
Come on, CJ. Really? You're not yanking my chain, are you?
No, Toonmore. You can go see the movie and review it. Because you deserve it. Think of it as a Christmas gift. Well, one of 2 Christmas gifts.
Oh, thank you, Wait. 2 Christmas gifts? Oh god, there's a catch, isn't there? Come on, I already owe a favor to that demonic geisha bitch from hell!
Well, technically, this would be a late Christmas gift, which means it will be a surprise for you during the following year. I won't say when it is and what it will be, because that would ruin the surprise.
Ugh, fine! What choice do I have, anyway? See you in Season 7, I guess. Oh god, what do I got myself into? Toonmore out!
A complete mess of a film, Toon. An utter travesty for my own enjoyment.
Season's greetings, everyone! I'm Hewy Toonmore. Welcome to Hewy's Anime Movie Reviews, the show where I review anime films from old to recent, whether they be hand-drawn, stop-motion, or computer-generated. You know, the Christmas season always reminds me of one of my absolute favorite fairy tales, Hans Christian Andersen's The Snow Queen.
Written in 1845, the story involves 2 siblings, Kai and Gerda, struggling between good and evil during the winter. It is considered to be one of the longest stories from Andersen's library, and is also a critically acclaimed hit, so much so that it would be reprinted into numerous illustrated storybooks for children and would be adapted into numerous media projects. The first time I was introduced to the story was by watching the Russian animated version from 1957, but for details on that, I would have to save it for another day when I do a review on it.
For the movie I'm reviewing today is a recent adaptation made by none other than Walt Disney Animation. Loose adaptation, but an adaptation nonetheless. And just in time for Christmas. Look, I know it's not technically a Christmas movie, but since you guys have been asking me to review it for over a year now, who am I to say no? Anyway, released on November 27th, 2013, the movie is Frozen.
And because it's still in theaters, I will not reveal anything that might spoil the ending or anything important for you. Now, on with the review. 2 princesses, Elsa and Anna, rule over the land of Arendelle. Elsa has the ability to create snow and ice, but suppressed these powers after a traumatic childhood incident involving Anna. And after her cryokinetic powers got out of hand during her official July coronation, she goes into hiding. But her emotions trigger a magical eternal winter that freezes the entire kingdom. Anna, a fearless and daring optimist, must journey with the extreme mountain man Kristoff, his reindeer sidekick Sven, and a comical snowman named Olaf in an epic journey to find Elsa, save their kingdom from eternal winter, and make things right before it's too late.
So, now that I'm done explaining the synopsis, what did I personally think of the movie? It was really good. not great, but yeah, really good. But to understand why I like the film, let's move on to trivia time.
The idea of adapting the Snow Queen as an animated feature was worked on by Walt Disney and Sam Goldwyn as far back as 1943, around the same time as when the first works for The Little Mermaid was planned. They found it troublesome to do, due to how they would characterize the Snow Queen to a modern audience, so it ended up being shelved. Many works since the 1990s got scrapped and rewritten many times, and it wasn't until in 2010 when the adaptation finally came to light. In the director's chair would be Chris Buck, who directed such other animated films as Disney's Tarzan and Surf's Up for Sony, along with Jennifer Lee, one of the writers of Wreck-It Ralph and Tangled, who also shares writing credits with Shane Morris, who did Dukes of Hazzard: The Beginning?
One of these things is not like the other one.
Speaking of story, one of the main things that differentiate this adaptation from the original source material is the character of Elsa. In the book, the Snow Queen was pictured as the villain. Here, they made her into a princess that can't control her powers properly by distraction of fear. And because of it, some people think of Elsa as a monster. Also, Elsa was given a sister, Anna, in which, throughout the film, focuses more on their relationship, which is rare in other Disney films, especially when they are both princesses, in which I see as a new feat, never done before in a Disney movie as of yet. Yet another marketing tool for the Disney Princess franchise. However, I do have two nitpicks with the story. One is that I wish they did follow the plot of the original story, since it already seemed like something you'd see in a Disney movie. Oh well, at least there's still the Russian animated version.
And if you've seen my Tangled review, then you know that my other nitpick would be, of course, the title change.
Having the movie titled Frozen makes me think of that thriller movie of the same name from 3 years ago. You know, the one where a group of people are trapped on a ski lift?
Don't you think it's a little too soon to reuse such a generic title as that, Disney? I mean, why not call it The Ice Princess, or The Snow Sisters, or just keep the original title of The Snow Queen? Then again, this is Disney of the 2010s, so I guess I should just get used to it.
As for the animation, like Tangled and Wreck-It Ralph before it, it is flawless. And the way the snow is presented, the snowfalls, the biting wind, the blizzards, it makes you feel like you're actually there. Also, the cultural theme actually goes quite well with this movie, seeing as that they chose a Swiss and Scandinavian theme. The ice on the stairs in the palace look as if you could touch it. Heck, the snow looks like you could actually play in it. As for the character models, I really like them. The style reminds me of what they did for Tangled, taking the traditional Disney hand-drawn style of Glenn Keane and translating it to 3D. Surprising since Glenn Keane didn't work on this movie.
Now, since this is a Disney princess movie, that also means it's a musical. And to be honest, the songs are sort of a mixed bag for me.
The two most interesting ones, in my opinion, are the Ice Cutter's song, Frozen Hearts, which has a rustic Scandinavian feel to it, kind of like a man's version of Whistle While You Work.
Born of cold and winter air and mountain rain combining, this icy force, both foul and fair, has a frozen harbor mining.
And Let It Go, sung by Queen Elsa, which is the very song that you'd likely hear to throw your troubles away.
The cold never bothered me anyway.
Now, I'd like to talk about the other songs, but as I've stated already, it's a mixed bag for me. But I also don't want to spoil any songs that you might find enjoyable. However, one of the songs that I had no interest in whatsoever is the Troll song.
And though we know he washes well, he always ends up sort of smelly.
But you'll never meet a fellow who's as sensitive and sweet.
I don't know, I just don't feel comfortable whenever I listen to it. Just seems out of place in my opinion. And if you watch the movie, then you'll know what I mean. So, now that we're done with trivia, animation, and songs, let's go over the characters and the voice actors who brought each one of them to life.
Our main protagonist, Princess Anna, is voiced by Kristen Bell, most famous for her role of Veronica Mars from the hit TV series of the same name. The performance Kristen did for Princess Anna, I see, is well done, portraying a young princess who is not only caring in relation to her sister, but also curious of finding out what true love is. Almost like Giselle from Enchanted, only not as flighty. Next is her sister, Queen Elsa, voiced by Idina Menzel, who's most famous for portraying Elphaba in the acclaimed Broadway musical Wicked. Speaking of which, her portrayal of the Snow Queen is almost eerily similar to Elphaba, a character who is thought to be evil when in truth is someone who is struggling with fear on using her powers properly and doesn't want to hurt anyone. Then there's Kristoff, voiced by Jonathan Groff, who did the Broadway musical Spring Awakening, an icebreaker who sells ice for a living with his reindeer Sven. At times when Kristoff speaks to Sven, he tends to throw his voice and make impressions to what Sven would say, kind of like a ventriloquist with a dummy, only he never makes Sven's lips move. I kind of like this kind of relationship. Almost reminds me of Flynn and Maximus from Tangled, only it felt like they've done this trick before and it's not original to the movie. But that doesn't mean I still can't like it. The comic relief, Olaf, is voiced by Josh Gad, who I've never heard of before and I can't find anything memorable he was ever in. Olaf is a snowman of Elsa and Anna's childhood who was brought to life by Elsa during her song Let It Go, which he then used the information to help Anna to find her sister. Olaf also wants to feel of what summer's like despite the fact that he's, well, a snowman. Now, when I went in to see this movie, I was afraid that because of his design and how the advertising portrayed him, that he was going to be an annoying character. Thank God I was wrong. I found Olaf to be a very comical, yet endearing character. I guess this is a case of not judging a book by its cover. Finally, there's the Duke of Weaseltown, I mean Weselton, voiced by Alan Tudyk, who's most famous for portraying Wash in the criminally underrated TV series Firefly. Now, to be honest, he did do a good job of playing such an underhanded scoundrel as the Duke, but I didn't even know it was him in the role. His voice sounded more like voice actor Maurice LaMarche, who portrays Elsa and Anna's father in the movie. I guess some people have similar voices in the world, which can be handy for when one person goes, would always be a replacement.
And now for my final thoughts on the film.
Overall, while Frozen may not be the Disney adaptation of the Snow Queen I was waiting for, it was still a pretty good and entertaining film. It focuses more on the relationship of sisters rather than the actual story, and it makes a nice change when it comes to true love. Though, in my opinion, while not all the songs in the movie were that enjoyable or memorable, surprising since they are written by the same team who did the recent Winnie the Pooh movie, it makes up for it with its Scandinavian scenery and landscapes. As for Anna and Elsa, I think they are a welcome addition to the Disney Princess franchise and have made history as the first Disney Princess sisters. I give this movie 5 stars. Not exactly a Disney classic, but it comes pretty close. And I mean pretty close.
And with that said, another review comes to an end, along with Season 6 of Hewy's Anime Movie Reviews. Be sure to join me again next year for Season 7. Till then, this is Hewy Toonmore saying, see the movies! Anime movies, that is. Oh, and have a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and a Happy New Year.